In the previous lesson, we learned how to do keyword research. The three steps were gathering keyword ideas, selecting and prioritizing your keywords, and categorizing your keywords. The second step, selecting and prioritizing your keywords, is crucial. And that's because the keywords we select will ultimately determine the SEO strategy and the resources we'll need in order to see results. Put simply, we need to think carefully about the keywords we choose in order not to overstretch ourselves or even set ourselves up for failure. So in this lesson, we'll take a closer look at the principles behind selecting and prioritizing keywords. The attributes we'll focus on are keyword search volume, keyword difficulty or competition, and keyword relevancy. Let's start with keyword search volume. Keyword search volume is an indication of how often a keyword is searched for in a given time. For example, if you're thinking about targeting a keyword, knowing how often that keyword was searched for in the previous 3 months would be a handy thing to know. As for figuring out what makes a good search volume to aim for, well, that depends on a few things. The industry and the scope of the search are two big factors. For example, a local search for a chiropractor in most towns will probably be a low search volume query, meaning few people search for this on a monthly basis. Whereas a dentist in a big city will see thousands of searches performed every single month. Also, some niches have lower search volume compared to other niches, even if the scope is wide. For example, there is less demand for a taxidermist than there is for a plumber, even in big cities. Understanding this will help you decide whether to include keywords with low search volume in your campaign. Generally, if you're just starting out or your website doesn't have a lot of authority, a good rule of thumb is to aim for keywords that have a search volume of between 100 and 1,000. This range ensures that there's decent traffic and that usually the competition is not too high, assuming that competitors are targeting higher search volume keywords. One exception to this rule are long-tail keywords, which generally do have lower search volume. For example, the search query dentist in Manchester has a lot of search volume, but the long tail search private dentist in Manchester has less search volume, but it also has less competition. Long tail keywords can be highly relevant and attract quality traffic, so don't hesitate to use these in your campaign, even if the search volume is low. We'll talk more about long tail keywords in a moment. Seasonality is the second attribute we need to consider before choosing a keyword. As we saw in the previous lesson, some keywords have a high search volume during certain times of the year and a significant drop-off in the off-season. For example, some types of fishing can be seasonal depending on what and where you're fishing. So a fishing blog targeting these type of keywords would normally see a significant drop in traffic in the off-season. Then there's trends. Some keywords can be popular as the result of a trend. The danger here is that the traffic usually disappears when the trend is over. Remember the Atkins diet? Who's searching for that now? And some keywords are evergreen, meaning they get searched for all year round and have a stable search volume over time. For example, weight loss. The diet may change, but the keyword will be popular forever. So here's what I suggest when it comes to evergreen and seasonal keywords. Seasonal keywords are mostly about news, trends, hobbies, or holiday specific. Things like holiday promotions, such as the Christmas season, are predictable and you can plan your content in advance to capture some of that search volume. On the other hand, news and trends are unpredictable. Think celebrity news and gossip blogs. So capitalizing on this requires being proactive and fast in your content production in order to stay up to date. Think carefully about targeting this type of keyword if you're not too confident on the quality of your content or if you think the trend will pass soon. Your time could be wasted. On the other hand, if you can produce quality, timely content, your website could just stand out. When it comes to evergreen keywords, these are a sustainable source of traffic, but it takes time for your web pages to rank high for this type of keyword because there's usually plenty of competition from other websites targeting this type of search term. But once your website ranks for evergreen keywords, it makes for a reliable traffic source for the long term. Another thing you might want to consider when choosing keywords is whether to target local searches. Local searches have less search volume than national and global searches, but the traffic is usually much more targeted. If a local search makes sense for your situation, definitely target it. Any good keyword tool should let you see local search volumes by country as well as by language. Another very important thing to consider when choosing keywords is keyword difficulty. Keyword difficulty is a measurement of how much effort it would take to rank for a keyword on page 1 of Google. All good keyword tools should provide a measurement of the keyword difficulty in terms of competitiveness. This is usually represented as high, medium, or low. A good strategy is to also consider the cost per click, or CPC. Advertisers are paying for a keyword. Those are the ads you see on most results pages. The number of advertisers drives up the cost of advertising, so the higher the cost per click for a keyword, the more competitive it is. That's always a good indication that there's money to be made. If the keywords you're targeting are directly related to a product or service, for example, air conditioning in Idaho or plumber in Toronto, make sure you check out the top 10 competitors to assess how difficult it will be to beat them. Things to consider when evaluating your competitors include whether their domain names include the keyword as well as their branding, the number of backlinks and referring domains they have, how many competitive keywords they're already ranking for in high positions, and the quality of their content and landing pages. Of course, knowing about the niche you're targeting will help you better assess the quality of the content of your competition. An advanced technique you can use is finding keywords with high search volume and low competition. This is known as the golden ratio, which we'll be covering in the next chapter, Advanced Keyword Research. Keyword relevancy is another attribute you should consider before choosing a keyword. Relevancy is determined by the search engine, and it's one of the most, if not the most, important ranking factor. All things being well, as long as you're ticking all the other boxes, like having a trustworthy website, having good quality content, and targeting achievable keywords, the more relevant your content is, the better it will rank. And when it comes to increasing your relevancy, the best strategy at your disposal is topical authority. Topical authority, as the name implies, is having authority over a topic. For example, if your website is about exercise, then having content on topics that directly affect exercise, such as sleep, nutrition, and supplementation, will increase your overall topical authority, which will in turn make your content more relevant to somebody searching for information on exercise. Informational and consideration keywords, which we covered in the previous lesson, can really help you increase your topical authority. So make sure you include those in your content. So once you define the best relevant keywords with high search volume and low competition, the next step is to devise a good content plan to help your website build topical authority. A great strategy to help with this is called keyword clustering, and we'll be covering that in the next chapter, Advanced Keyword Research. Now let's talk about short tail keywords and long tail keywords. Short tail keywords are 1, 2, and sometimes 3 word search terms, like Nike or Nike shoes. They're also known as head terms, and because they're so short, they tend to cover a very broad range of topics. So they get a lot more traffic than long tail keywords, and as a result, are much more competitive. However, more traffic is not better if it's not targeted traffic. Short tail keywords attract a lot of poor quality traffic. An online store that ranks for Nike shoes, other than Nike of course, is unlikely to have every single type of Nike shoe in every color and size available. That means a lot of that traffic will not convert. Long tail keywords, on the other hand, contain 3 or more words, which means that you can be much more descriptive and specific. The long tail keyword Nike Air Max size 9 men's blue will get a lot less search traffic than Nike shoes. But that traffic will convert a lot better because most people that click on that link, you would assume, are looking for those shoes. Now, when it comes to choosing between these two types of keywords, one clear advantage of short tail keywords is that they are usually evergreen keywords. Things like mortgage advice, dating program, and investing tips are always going to be popular. Short tail keywords can also improve your brand recognition and reputation. I mean, imagine ranking first for insurance or mortgage. And they can, of course, bring an enormous amount of organic traffic to your website. However, when you consider all 3 keyword attributes, which is the basis of how we select and prioritize keywords, short tail keywords don't make the cut. Long tail keywords have a higher conversion rate when it comes to click-through traffic because of the high relevance and the alignment with the customer's search intent. And here's a great benefit of targeting long tail keywords. As you start to rank high for long tail keywords, you'll start to attract short tail keywords as your website's topical authority and relevance increase, bringing you all the benefits of short tail keywords. In the next lesson, we'll be covering advanced keyword research. I'll see you there.